It's a day in the life
of the Hudson River!
Shorefronts along the Hudson River and the piers of New York Harbor are busy with activity as thousands of students of all ages participate in a day in the life of the Hudson and Harbor.
This is a one-day field-based community science program where students are the scientists. They're visiting their local waterfront communities to explore the Hudson River. They're equipped with fishing nets and water testing gear, and students collect data on water quality and living things in the Hudson, all to gain a better understanding about their river.
What is unique about the river is its dynamic character. The Hudson River runs 315 miles from Lake Tear of the Clouds, perched over 4,000 feet up on Mount Marcy in the Adirondacks, all the way to New York Harbor. While the northern part of the river is freshwater fed by snowmelt, groundwater, and rain, the southern section is a tidal mix of salty seawater and freshwater.
An estuary is a place where freshwater from a river joins with saltwater from an ocean. The estuary makes up the lower half of the Hudson River, spanning 153 miles from the Troy Dam out to the Atlantic Ocean. Here, the river experiences dramatic changes in salinity, tides, and currents. The indigenous Stockbridge Munsee community's name for the river is Mahiakantuk, which means the waters that are never still.
Collecting data is one aspect of day in the life. Water quality can tell us a lot about the health of the river. For example, measuring dissolved oxygen can indicate healthy waters for plants and animals. Fish breathe dissolved oxygen in the water. Here at Norrie Point, which is 85 miles north of the Atlantic Ocean, we have collected a variety of freshwater fish species over the years on day in the life, like this red-breasted sunfish. Learning about what fish live in the river can tell us a lot about the habitats that we have here in the area.
We also measure how much salt is in the water. The salinity can range depending on where you are in the Hudson. And here in Piermont, which is just 25 miles north of New York City, we have slightly salty water. This mix of fresh and salty water is called brackish, and species such as striped bass and Atlantic silverside thrive in brackish waters.
Here in New York Harbor, near the Atlantic Ocean, the salty water provides habitats for many animals such as the lined seahorse, blue crabs, and many other saltwater species. It's incredible what species you can find hiding amongst the piers in New York City, including this American oyster.
Through these hands-on investigations, students measure turbidity, temperature, and weather parameters. And using this collected data, we can produce a much larger snapshot of the Hudson River all on one day.
These dramatic and dynamic features are what we hope to capture in our annual snapshot of the Hudson River. And we hope that through participation in this event, students will discover as many questions as they answer to create a lifelong learning relationship with the river.